recently diagnosed with type 2 diabetes. He'll be sent home with Lispro and Glargine insulin. The patient states, "I always said I'd never give myself shots like random avenues. Can't these be given in pills? We're going to teach you."
Hi. Can you tell me what you know about diabetes?
Well, I got the diagnosis last week, and I went on the website for the American Diabetes Association and got a brochure, so I know a little bit about why my blood sugar is too high.
Yes, and as your doctor explained to you, diabetes is a progressive disease, and because your disease wasn't diagnosed for a long period of time, it progressed to the point where your pancreas is not really producing sufficient insulin. Since insulin doesn't come in pill form, you'll need to take insulin injections.
So I really don't want shots.
Well, insulin doesn't come in pill form because if you were to take a pill, it would destroy the insulin right when you hit the stomach acid. So instead, it has to be injected into the fat under your skin so it can get into your bloodstream eventually. It's a really tiny needle.
We'll see.
Well, uncontrolled diabetes increases a person's risk for a lot of serious illnesses, like heart disease, stroke, hypertension, eye problems, including blindness, kidney issues, neurological, and vascular damage. In fact, 60% of all non-traumatic lower limb amputations are caused by diabetes.
Wow.
Yeah. The good news is, with your careful management and control, you can greatly reduce the chances of these life-threatening complications.
Well, I like that.
Two ones. We have assessed this patient prior to coming in for his readiness to learn about medications. Bernie, can you tell me what you know about insulin?
Not too much. I know that my doctor prescribed the one called Glargine and one called Lispro.
That's correct. She has ordered both a long-term and a rapid-acting insulin. They're both an anti-diabetic pancreatic hormone used to treat type 2 diabetes.
Which one's which?
Well, the long-term the doctor's ordered is called Glargine and goes by the brand name Lantus. The rapid-acting insulin you would prescribe is called Lispro, also known as Humalog. And many healthcare providers use this combination as known as a basal bolus regimen. And it's to mimic the natural insulin changes that help keep your blood sugar control. Okay? Glargine is the basal, which is the long-acting insulin. It provides a relatively steady level of insulin throughout the day, and it replaces the action your body can't do anymore. It basically keeps your insulin levels steady meals and while you're sleeping. And it also reduces your risk for hypoglycemia because it lacks a peak action. It's just kind of a steady. The Lispro is the rapid acting insulin. It's known as a bolus. And it is a quick, rapid acting, short-lived insulin to that insulin when you eat meals. It has an onset of about 15 to 20 minutes, so it's going to take care of that insulin level that you need. It works, its maximum, it's called the peak, is about 1 hour, and it only lasts for about 3 to 6 hours, so it works off.
Oh, yeah, and my blood sugar goes up after a meal, so that makes sense.
That's correct. And it's easy to remember that both of these insulins are clear, so it's important to remember that Glargine cannot, well, it is important to remember that Glargine can't be mixed together with the Lispro or any other. So, can you tell me a little bit about what I just talked to you about as far as the differences? And
yeah, I've got one that I'm going to take that is once a day that will just be a baseline level that will keep me my blood sugar Oh, so I'll